Ah, oh, beautiful spot. I'm only too pleased to help, and I'm in the school.
Exactly, my dear sir. Good morning.
Oh, good morning.
Well, Francis?
A small matter, Henry, a small matter.
Nevertheless, I detect the sound of distant thunder.
It is my distasteful duty to speak of Dodgson again.
Oh, he's been attending the theatre in London. I gave him permission.
Come, come, Francis.
It all depends which way you want to go. You like duchesses, he prefers the theatre. In his case, an innocent diversion. He has many.
His latest literary impertinence is a poem, if you please, addressed to the Queen, suggesting that the bell, our bell, Rick Tom, be removed after 200 years.
Where's it being published?
It hasn't yet. For all we know, he was planning to recite it to the Queen when she arrives. A man's mad, downright dangerous. Judge for yourself.
How did you come by this?
Oh, found its way to me. Such things often do, somehow. Shall we send for him?
No, no. I'll attend to it presently.
Presently? He's out there capering with your children.
Still Ellis.
Ellis? Diggle. I can't help it. There's a fly on my nose.
There are no flies in China. Dragons, griffins. Now, conceal the string in the grass, just as we planned. And I then take my place among you heathens. So, I now count 10. That is, I shall grunt 10 times under my breath, precisely as we practiced it. Are you ready?
But, Mr. Dodgson...
No buts, no changes. Eyes on the lens. Are you ready?
Charming costumes.
Yes, they were lent me by a theatrical friend.
Just a moment, Dodgson. I want a word with you. I gather you've been thinking of leaving Oxford. Oxford's an anchor, you know, Dodgson. Without it, you may be battered by the four winds. I should be very sad indeed to think of your drifting away without once stopping to think how in the world you could ever get back again. But perhaps you don't feel like that.
Oh, yes, I do, dear.
Or are the children becoming tiresome?
On the contrary. I don't want to leave Oxford. Only? Nothing ever changes here.
If it did, it wouldn't be Oxford any longer. Great Tom, for example. I gather you'd suggest some change there. You know, it was a gift from Charles II.
Charles II hasn't... personally been disturbed by it since 1685.
You consider it a noisy nuisance?
Well, everyone does. Everyone says so in private.
But we haven't the courage to tell the sovereign.
Exactly, sir. And I think somebody should, after 200 years.
Very well, then. You tell her yourself when she visits us next week.
Liddell.
Dr. Liddell.
He has three little girls, Lorena, Edith, and Alice.
Lorena, Edith, and Alice.
He writes Greek lexicons and has a collection of incunabula in his library.
Incunabula?
Old books.
Not a bit, sir.
Liddell. Mrs. Liddell wishes you to come at once. Most important. It concerns the arrangement of the tongues.
And by the way, I think it would be more orderly if the children remained in their rooms.
Your children, sir, they'll be dreadfully disappointed not being present. If they promise faithfully to behave...
Oh, impossible, Dodson. They'll have to stay in their rooms. But don't worry, they'll have an excellent view of the proceedings.
I say, Dodson, if what I hear is true, our ears will be grateful to you.
I've suffered from that bell for 18 years.
Chancellor says so.
But I want to see the Queen.
Hello, Dinah.
Dinah wants to see her, too.
Oh, that would never do.
A cat may look at a queen. You told me that yourself.
Merely a figure of speech. And I'm sure I said, at a king.
Oh, I'll never believe you again. You're not my friend.
That being the case,
I'll take this back.
You stole it. You stole one of the Queen's tarts.
Present the Dean, Dr. Little.
How do you do? And how are Lorena, Edith, and Alice, Dr. Little?
Very well, thank you, ma'am. I'm honored that Your Majesty shows an interest in my children. May I present Mr. Smith of the Faculty Literary Humaniores? Our lecturer in mathematics, Mr. Charles Dodson.
Otherwise known as Lewis Carroll. I've read some of your verse in the Illustrated News. Charming, perfectly charming. And what is the subject of your latest poem?
Ma'am, it concerns tradition. It's a poem about the bell. Our bell of Christchurch, Great Tom.
Yes, that magnificent bell. It is stimulating to know that come what may, Great Tom will ring throughout the ages.
Come to think of it, nothing quite so impressive in the whole university as the voice of Great Tom, is there?
Will order us a tea?
Ah, tea. We shall be very pleased. And after that, we should like to go to the library and see your collection of incunabula.
You'll see the Queen's carriage straight ahead of you as it drives back across the bridge.
Queen herself is still at the house.
Yes, but in the library. We've seen the library dozens of times.
Not with the Queen in it.
Precisely. That's why I couldn't possibly tell you a story there.
A story?
A story about a little girl named Alice.
I don't want to hear it. What does Alice do?
She visits a strange land where strange people do strange things. All right, I won't tell it.
Yes, tell it, tell it.
No.
The eyes apparently have it.
Then I hope there's some animals in it. And nonsense.
What could be pleasanter? Very well. It happened like this. Alice was beginning to get very tired of sitting by her sister on the bank and of having nothing to do.
Suddenly, a white rabbit with pink eyes ran close by her. Burning with curiosity, she ran after it. It was just in time to see it pop down a large rabbit hole.
Either this well is very deep, or I'm falling very slowly. Well, after such a fall as this, I shall think nothing of falling downstairs. How brave they'll all think me at home. Why, I wouldn't say anything about it, even if I fell off the top of the house. I wonder how many miles I've fallen by this time. I wonder what latitude or longitude I've got to. I must be getting somewhere near the center of the earth. Curiouser and curiouser.
Oh, my ears and whiskers, how late it is getting. What will the Queen say?
over me like that?
I couldn't help it. Seven jogged my elbow.
That's right, Five. Always lay the blame on others.
You better not talk. I heard the Queen say only yesterday you deserve to be beheaded.
What for?
That's none of your business, too.
I'm sure the Queen would be interested in what you are doing. Why are you painting those roses?
Well, the fact is, you see, sir, this here ought to have been a red rose tree.
And we put a white one in by mistake.
And if the Queen was to find it out, we should have all our heads cut off.
So you see, sir.
Yes, I see.
You won't tell the Queen, sir.
She'll have us executed, sir.
Please, sir, you were once in our shoes.
But I was clever enough to get out of them. And today I play croquet with the Queen.
I was the very least of the very largest litter of the very poorest family in the wood. My troubles never ceased, and my life was very bitter, till I learned the knack of grabbing what I could.
He followed all the rules, all right, all right.
The rules I make up as I go along. A woman say day is night. I thought, what an awful dunce. To say that day is night is silly. I'll tell her so at once. But when I saw that the woman was the Queen, the case was not the same. But she said it once again.
Yes.
And I cried, Your Majesty.
Yes.
I absolutely agree with you.
That was day, the day.
What does it get us?
Step
by step, I gain my ends.
Spending
only on my friends. Loyal till I'm bought. To both sides till I'm caught.
I'm much too big. I wish I could shut up like a telescope. It's all very well to say drink me, but I've heard that if you drink from a bottle marked poison, it's almost certain to disagree with you sooner or later. This bottle is not marked poison. Pineapple toffee, roast turkey, and hot buttered toast. What a queer feeling. I must be shutting up like a telescope. Now I'm just the right size for going into that lovely garden. I can't be more than 10 inches high. Thank you.
ears and whiskers.
If you please, sir. By the fire purring.
How picturesque. How very picturesque. By the fire purring. Purring? Did you say purring?
Yes.
Purring. Dinah's a cat! Capital of London. How exasperating. I know I shall catch my death of cold.
What was that?
Who's
It was 10 years ago.
It was a cloudburst.
A tidal wave.
Cloudburst.
Tidal wave.
The question is, how shall we get dry? Do I hear a motion? One at a time, please.
Why one at a time?
All at the same time goes faster.
We'll all speak when we please. One at a time. So undignified. The obvious conclusion is it must have been done by a stranger.
Are you all ready? This is the driest thing I know. William the Conqueror.
William the Conqueror.
Whose cause?
Whose cause?
Was favored by the Pope.
Favored by the Pope.
Was soon submitted to by the English.
Submitted by
Edwin and Morcar.
Edwin and Morcar.
The Earls of Mercia.
Earl
and Northumbria.
I beg your pardon. Did you speak?
Not I!
In that case, I move that the meeting adjourn for the immediate adoption of more energetic remedies.
Mary Ann, what are you doing out here? Run home this moment and fetch me a pair of gloves and a fan. Quick now.
I'd better hurry before he finds out who I am. He must have taken me for his housekeeper. Queer it seems to be doing messages for a rabbit. What a lovely house. It's just right for a rabbit.
If I grow any smaller, I shall disappear altogether. This must make me grow big.
Whatever can be keeping that girl? So my fur and whiskers. Fat! Hey, Bill, where are you?
I'm here, Your Honor, digging for apples.
Digging for apples, indeed. Come here at once. What's that in the window?
It's an arm, Your Honor.
An arm, your goose? Whoever saw one that size?
It's an arm for all that.
Well, it's got no business there. Take it away. Do as I tell you, you cowards. No, no, no. Get me out of this. Now, quick. The ladder. Bring the large one. No, that ladder is too short.
Oh, dear. I wonder what they'll do. I wish I had gone down that rabbit hole.
That's it, then. Now, then, it's down the chimney. Who is it to be? Volunteers!
goes Bill! There goes Bill! My house! What shall I do?
Only one thing to do. Burn down the house.
No, 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 no! No, no! A pebble? That's right, you can't.
Eat me. Oh, if only it makes me smaller. These creatures chase after me so. I had to kick Bill a little, and I didn't mean to turn on that flood.
Undignified.
Obviously, it must have been a stranger.
And when that stranger is brought before the Queen, off with his head.
Is a head.
Huh?
Look. A gal.
I told you she did it.
No, I don't.
Female criminal.
And so young, too.
So young and yet so hard.
She doesn't look it.
If she were my daughter.
In the name of the Queen, forward.
I hardly know, sir, just at present.
Explain yourself.
I can't explain myself, sir, because I'm not myself, you see.
I don't see, not at all, ma'am.
I'm afraid I can't put it much more clearly. Being so many different sizes in a day is very confusing.
What size do you want to be?
Well, I should like to be a little larger, sir, if you don't mind. 3 inches is such a wretched height.
It's a very good height indeed, 3 inches. Wretched.
Oh, I wish you creatures wouldn't be so easily offended.
You? Who are you?
I don't know. can't seem to remember things.
Can't seem to remember things. Recite, you are old, Father William.
You are old, Father William, the young man said, and your hair has become very white. And yet you incessantly stand on your head. Do you think at your age it is right? It is right.
In my youth, Father William replied to his son, I fear it might injure my brain. But now that I'm perfectly sure I have none, why I do it again and again.
You are old, said the youth. One would hardly suppose that your eye was as steady as ever. Yet you balanced an eel on the end of your nose. What makes you so awfully clever?
I have answered three questions, and that is enough, said his father. Don't give yourself airs. Do you think I can listen all day to such stuff? Be off, or I'll kick you downstairs. Be off, or I'll kick you downstairs.
An invitation from the Queen to play croquet.
From the Queen? An invitation for the Duchess to play croquet.
We're fish and yet we're
Queen's tarts, by any chance?
Please, sir, won't tell Her Majesty.
Tell her what? You didn't steal them. Haven't you heard?
They were stolen by a stranger.
There's no sort of use in docking. That for two reasons. First, because I'm on the same side of the door as you are. Secondly, because they're making such a noise inside, no one could possibly hear you.
Perhaps you can tell me.
There might be some sense in your docking if we had the door between us. For instance, if you were inside, you might dock and I could let you out, you know.
It's really dreadful the way all you creatures argue.
I shall sit here till tomorrow. Or next day, maybe.
How am I to get in?
Are you to get in at all? That's the first question, you know.
But what am I to do?
Anything you like.
It's enough to drive one crazy. Going to turn into a pig, my dear, I'll have nothing more to do with you. Mind now. If he had grown up, he would have been a dreadfully ugly child. But he makes a rather handsome pig. Please, which way I ought to walk from here?
That depends a good deal where you want to go. In that direction lives a hatter, and in that direction lives a march hare. Visit either you like. They are both mad.
But I want to visit the queen. I don't want to go among mad people.
Oh, you can't help that. We're all mad here. I'm mad. You're mad.
I'm mad?
You must be, or you wouldn't have come here.
Well, how do you know you're mad?
To begin with, a dog's not mad. You grant that?
I suppose so.
Well, then, a dog growls when it's angry and wags its tail when it's pleased. But I growl when I'm pleased and wag my tail when I'm angry. Therefore, I'm mad. Do you play croquet with the Queen today?
I should like to very
much. You'll see me there.
Curious and curious.
By the by, what became of the baby?
It turned into a pig.
I thought it would.
Let me see. The March Hare lives that way.
Did you say pig or fig?
I said pig. And I wish you wouldn't keep appearing and vanishing so suddenly.
All right.
I've seen many a cat without a grin. But a grin without a cat? I'm afraid of that rabbit, though I don't know why I should be. After all, he's only a rabbit. This must be the March Hare's house. Tea. And I'm so hungry.
No room, no room.
There's plenty of room.
Your hair wants cutting.
You oughtn't to make personal remarks. It's very rude.
Have some lemonade.
I don't see any lemonade.
There isn't any.
Then it wasn't very civil of you to offer it.
It's not very civil of you to sit down without being invited. Is a raven like a writing desk?
That's a riddle.
I believe I can guess it.
Do you mean you think you can find out the answer to it?
Exactly so.
You should say what you mean.
I do say what I mean. At least I mean what I say, and that's the same thing.
It's not the same thing a bit. Why? You might just as well say, I see what I eat. It's the same as I eat what I see.
I just as well say that I like what I get. It's the same thing as I get what I like.
I might just as well say, when I breathe, when I sleep, it's the same thing as I sleep when I breathe.
It is the same with you.
Oh. Let's all move up one place. What day of the month is it?
The fourth.
Oh, 2 days long. He went mad last March, you know. It was at a great concert given by the Queen. I was singing.
First verse, when the Queen bawled out, "He's murdering the time! Off with his head!"
How dreadfully savage.
Oh, but I did murder the time. And ever since then, it's always been tea time.
Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder what you're at.
To go.
I don't care where.
Then it doesn't matter which way you go.
So long as I get somewhere.
Oh, you're sure to do that if you only walk long enough.
Long enough? If you only walk long enough. I have got somewhere. It's the bottom of the sea.
Queen of Hearts.
Oh.
What a lovely day for croquet and for chopping off a few heads. What's your name, child?
My name is Alice, so please, Your Majesty.
And who are these? Turn them over. Get up. Leave off that, you make me giddy. What have you been doing here?
May it please Your Majesty?
Oh, I see. Off with their heads. Can you play croquet?
Yes. Yes, Your Majesty.
Then play. Either you or your head must be off, and that in about half no time. Take your choice. Play the game. Off with his head.
I can't cut off a head unless there's a body to cut it from. I never had to do such a thing before, and I'm not going to begin at my time of life.
Anything that has a head can be beheaded.
All I say is, if something isn't done about it in less than no time, I'll have everybody executed, all round.
There, my dear, its head is off. How do you like the Queen?
Not at all. She's so extremely likely to win that it's hardly worthwhile finishing the game.
You may have a cherry tart, my child.
Why, there are no tarts there, Your Majesty.
Nonsense, there must be. I made them myself.
But they are gone, my dear.
Of course the tarts are gone, Your Majesty. They have been stolen.
Stolen? My tarts stolen? Someone shall suffer for this. Off with his head. Off with his head. Off with his head. Off with his head. Off with his head.
Oh, we are entirely depopulated, my dear. Hadn't you better find out who did?
Yes, yes. Who did it? Who did it?
She did it.
Off with our head.
She has to stand trial first.
Why do we need a trial? All I want is to chop off her head.
Not without a trial. Fair play, you know.
She shall stand trial. And then we'll chop off her head.
Yes, that's fair.
Up, lazy thing!
What fun! Come on!
I don't see how he can ever finish if he doesn't begin. Who are you?
I was a real turtle. Now I'm a mock turtle.
What is a mock turtle?
The thing mock turtle soup is made of.
Queen of Hearts.
Consider your verdict.
Not yet. There's a great deal to come before that. I will read the charge. The Queen of Hearts, she made some tarts. All on a summer's day.
The Queen of Hearts, she made some tarts. All on a summer's day.
Gentlemen of the jury, those tarts have been stolen.
Stolen!
Call the first witness.
First witness? I beg pardon, Your Majesty, for bringing this in. But I hadn't quite finished my tea when I was sent for.
Write that down. It's very important. Give your evidence.
And don't be nervous or I'll have you executed! Hold these. I hadn't but just begun my tea, not over a week or so, and what with the bread and butter getting so thin, and the March Hare said...
No, it didn't.
You did.
I didn't.
He denied it. Leave out that part. What happened after that?
After that, I cut the more bread and butter.
Here, here.
You may go.
How I wonder what you're at.
Twinkle, twinkle, twinkle. Off with that Dormouse's head.
Allow me.
Thank you.
Perfectly all right.
Gentlemen of the jury, call the next witness.
Never mind the witness. Let's get to the execution.
Very well. Bring in the accused.
Alice, I believe?
Here.
Now then, what do you know about this business?
Nothing.
Write that down. It's very important.
Unimportant, Your Majesty means, of course.
Unimportant, of course, I meant. Important and important. Important and Rule 42. All persons more than a mile high to leave the court.
I'm not a mile high.
You are.
Nearly 2 miles high.
That's not a regular rule. You invented it just now.
It's the oldest rule in the book.
Then it ought to be number one.
Here, here.
Throw that Dormouse out.
Your Majesty, this paper has just been picked up.
What's in it?
I haven't read it yet, but it's written by the prisoner.
That isn't my handwriting.
She must have imitated someone else's hand.
That proves her guilt. Off with...
Read it.
Where shall I begin, please, Your Majesty?
Begin at the beginning. Go on until you come to the end. Then stop.
They told me you had been to her and mentioned me to him. She gave me a good character, but said I could not swim. He sent them word I had not gone. We know it to be true. If she should push the matter on, what would become of you? I gave her one, they gave him two. You gave us three or more. They all returned from him to you, though they were mine before. If I or she should chance to be involved in this affair, he trusts you to set them free exactly as we were. My notion was that you had been, before she had this fit, an obstacle that came between him and ourselves and it. Don't let him know she liked them best, for this must ever be a secret kept from all the rest between yourself and me.
That's the most important piece of evidence.
And you know what that means?
I don't believe there's an atom of meaning in it.
Let the jury consider the verdict.
No, let them consider the charge. The Queen of Hearts, she baked some tarts all on a summer's day. The Knave of Hearts, he stole the tarts and took them quite away.
It's perfectly true what she says. The Knave of Hearts did steal the tarts.
He did?
Only she is the Knave of Hearts.
Then who are you?
I am Alice.
She is the girl that stole the tarts.
Hold your tongue!
I won't! Off with her head!
Off with her head! Off with her head!
Who cares for you? You're nothing but a pack of cards.
The whole pack rose up into the air and came flying down upon her. She gave a little scream, half of fright and half of anger.
Oh. What happened to Alice?
Well, Alice found herself lying on the bank with her head in the lap of her sister, who was gently brushing away some dead leaves that had fluttered down from the trees upon her face. Oh, I've had such a curious dream, said Alice.
A dream? No, no, it was real. It was real. But Mr. Dodson, it was all real, wasn't it?
Natural.
Thank you.
Thank you.